Hey guys, welcome to a new cosplay vlog. I'm getting my makeup on to do a Catwoman look. It's my interpretation of Catwoman. There's been so many different variations over the years, and I had planned to do this one, and I have all the pieces and everything, and I was planning on doing it later, but you know what? I've been wanting to do another cosplay to lift my spirits a little bit, so I'm just getting my makeup on, just cover up and whatnot. I'm gonna do a like purple and black look, my eye look. I keep using my Catwoman mask like up on my face to see where things are hitting, like some of my contour and my blush a little bit. You know, some of the face makeup will be hidden under the mask, but the eye makeup will be alive and well. So I'm just using the mask to map out my face.
My mask taped to my face because it keeps trying to rise weird.
Can we talk about how my box fan is literally saving my life right now in this cat suit? I mean, I got a couple layers going on, like with the suit and the stuff under the suit and the belt and the wig cap and the wig and the headpiece and the gloves. A little toasty, but I'm getting used to it. It's not bothering me as bad as I'm filming, so.
So as I said, I kind of did my own spin on Catwoman. There has been a lot of different variations of the character, whether that is in comics, cartoons, movies, shows, etc. When I think of Catwoman, I usually always think of black and purple. I don't know why, probably because I used to have this poster of Catwoman in like a dark purple cat suit instead of just the black. So I kind of always relate purple and black to Catwoman. So for my Selina Kyle, I went ahead and went with that, with the flares of purple, the black cat suit. My eye makeup obviously has the purple flare as well, along with a belt, the Catwoman mask, of course, and then oftentimes Selina has dark hair, either dark brown hair or short black hair. I always tend to think of Catwoman with blonde hair, probably because of Michelle Pfeiffer, but there's once again a lot of variations. So for my version, I decided to go with a blonde Catwoman.
Well, I went to bed way earlier than I usually do, which means I get up at some insane time and I can't get back to sleep. So I'm going to throw on a cosplay I have ready and go shoot it out and about while it's still early and maybe not as many people around. Happy Saturday. What is my life out and about dressed as Ariel? What is my life?
Okay. Morning.
Um,
Little tiny bit, yeah.
Yeah,
thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Oh yeah, they're in the shop.
Your one little short part is sticking out again on the side.
Oh, this stupid thing?
Yeah.
That's all, folks. I would eat shit, you know I would. Oh, it's a perfect day for this. Absolutely perfect. I don't know where he's at now, but we met the nicest man while I was doing my cosplay shoot.
Bolted. Ooh, nope, that's too bright. Ugh.
I got a blister from my shoes in the 2.5 seconds I've been wearing them. Come on now. I was just telling my mom that I was preparing if there happened to be a little kid. It's pretty early out, but just in case there happened to be a little kid that like asked if I was Ariel, I was not gonna ruin their day. So like I was trying to game up my role-playing skills and make sure that I had something to say to this child just in case, but there were no children. Just a really nice older gentleman that was very kind and talkative. And was chill. And yeah. Okay, let's take a moment to talk about how spoiled my dog is. So my mom's gonna just run to the store and get some Gatorades for us since it's hotter out, and my dog loves to go bye-bye. But we don't take him anywhere. We do not leave him in the car. Like, he can go with us if like I'm gonna be in the car, or you know, we're not going in somewhere, just a drive-through, but I do not leave my dog in the car any time of the year. And he looks at me and he's all like whimpering. I was like, you little fucker. So now I gotta go out in Ariel in a cosplay because I spoil my dog.
Right, I think I'm done taking pictures and filming and walking around everywhere as Ariel. So I think I'm done, gonna take the cosplay off and look over the footage and chill and yeah.
Look at this stuff, isn't it neat? Wouldn't you think my collection's complete? Wouldn't you think I'm a girl who has everything? Look at this trove, treasures untold. How many wonders can one cavern hold? Looking around, do you think? Sure, she's got everything. I've got gadgets and gizmos of plenty. I've got goosets and whatsits galore. You want thingamabobs? I've got 20. But who cares? No big deal. I want more. I wanna be where the people are. I wanna see them dancing, walking around on those. What do you call them? No, feet. Flipping your fins, you don't get too far. Legs are required for jumping, dancing, strolling along down the, what's that word again? Street. Up where they walk, up where they run, up where they stay all day in the sun. Wandering free, wish I could be part of that world.
So just the ending of this vlog about the pieces I used for Ariel. This is an actual Disney dress that I got years ago. So it's all one piece and it's a great fit and super comfortable and fun for Ariel's blue dress look. And this piece together gives the corset type look for it. So pretty easy cosplay, but I really wanted to do this Ariel look. I was lucky in the ribbon that I got for Hades was perfect for the bow for in Ariel's hair, and of course the brighter red wig for Little Mermaid's
hair, of course, the bright red. And then I paired it with just these little slip-on heels, which I thought looked good for Ariel. These tore my feet apart, though. I forgot I had previously bought these for a previous job, and I gotta stretch them out or do something because I barely did any walking, just like from the car down the dock, and my poor feet are like tore up because of these really cute but apparently not very comfortable shoes. Okay, we all knew this would happen because of the movie. I had not planned to do any sort of Black Widow cosplay because I was like, maybe a lot of people will be doing it because of the movie. But then I see the movie and the suits are gorgeous. I want one of the Black Widow suits. They're so pretty, but alas, I do not have one of the suits and I do not have the funds to buy one of the suits. So I'm doing my interpretation of a Black Widow look. I made some props last night, and I'm going through some wigs right now, and I should be working on some other cosplays, but saw the movie, and now I'm inspired. We all knew this would happen.
Widow wigs.
My life is just kind of wigs right now.
Alright, full makeup on my arm, wig switches, tight clothing. I'm exhausted. Shower time.